What you want? Part 2, episode 155 of Top Rope Reality. I'm Mike Hogan.
I'm Justin Carter.
And here is the Pro Wrestling Review, the Monday Night Wars, September 1st through the 29th of 1997.
Absolutely.
Now, on September 1st of 1997, we only had a Nitro. Raw was not on...
Again?
Again, they were, took 2 weeks off. Great dog show.
Well, that's bad for business, 2 weeks off.
Well, they were off for 2 weeks, yes.
Not smart at all, but we start out with Chris Benoit and Steve Mongo McMichaels defeating Eddie Guerrero and Jeff Jarrett. Wow. 3 out of 4 of those can't stay away from each other.
That's true. We had Mortis defeating Silver King.
We had Euro Nagata. I always get it right. I don't
know
why.
You love that name.
Defeated Dean Malenko.
Ultimo Dragon defeated La Parka.
Chairman of the board. Buff the Stuff Bagwell defeated Glacier.
Lizmark Jr. defeated Villano IV.
Your WCW World Television Champion, Alex Wright.
Das Wunderkind.
Defeated Hugh Morrus.
But who hasn't?
Exactly.
Stevie Richards defeated Damien.
Not the snake.
No.
Rey Traylor, the big boss man, defeated Prince Iaukea.
Chris Jericho won a Cruiserweight Battle Royal. Don't have any people in it.
Right, we don't know. Could have been 5 of them.
Could have been most people who wrestled earlier.
That's true. And in your main event, Randy the Macho Man Savage and Scott Hall, the NWO, defeated DDP and Lex Luger. That's like a who's who.
Now Luger probably turned and joined the NWO.
Probably.
So next time we talk about Luger, he'll be part. Kevin Nash, go home. Lex Luger, like, what the hell? He was just...
Exactly. But at least it actually was a definitive win.
We went from a battle royal to a win. No DQ.
No DQ or no count out. No contest.
Yes. Now we go to Raw for September 8th. Nitro. Back to Nitro. Excuse me. Sorry about that. We go to Nitro again for September 8th as Rey Mysterio Jr. defeated Eddie Guerrero.
Booyaka, booyaka. Defeated Latino Heat. Hugh Morrus defeated Disco Inferno.
We have a Cruiserweight title match now as your champion, Chris Jericho, defeated Brad Armstrong by disqualification.
And then immediately retained his title against Eddie Guerrero in a Cruiserweight title match.
Somebody didn't like Jericho, did they?
Apparently not.
The Faces of Fear, being a barbarian, versus the Steiner Brothers, Rick and Scott, ended in a no contest.
We had to have at least one of those in there. Oh, never mind, we have two. Scott Hall defeated Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Dean Malenko defeated Psychosis.
Kurt Hennig and Ric Flair, as he was acting like he was part of the Four Horsemen, defeated Buff, the Stuff Bagwell, and Conan, not the Barbarian.
And why is the main event a no contest? Because DDP took on Lex Luger, who probably attacked him in the main event to let the NWO win the week before.
Isn't that weird?
It's like we saw it in the past.
We did. I didn't even read ahead. And then we go over to Nitro. Let's, or, no. And Raw. I'm so sorry. I got they I all bleed
Raw,
together.
Yeah, I was going to do Raw.
Raw for September the 8th. They've been off for 2 weeks. Let's see if they can redeem themselves.
I say no.
So far, I say no as well. As Bret Hart versus Vader ended in a no contest in a no-holds-barred match that lasted 11 minutes and 10 seconds. How do you get a no contest out of a no-holds-barred match? Which means anything can go.
Means that it couldn't go anymore. We had the Godwins, Henry and Phineas, defeat the Headbangers, Mosh and Thrasher, in 3 minutes and 5 seconds.
Max Mini defeated Pirata Morgan. I guess it's a pirate.
Little pirate, yeah,
little pirate. I don't know. 241.
Owen Hart with Bret Hart and the British Bulldog defeated Goldust by disqualification in a WWF Intercontinental Title Tournament quarterfinal match in 2 minutes and 9 seconds.
And then your main event is a three-way dance. It lasted 17 minutes, 4 seconds as Triple H with China and Shawn Michaels defeated Savio Vega and the Patriot. Wow, what a crappy main event. So let me get this straight. We have a no contest for the opening.
Yes.
And an DQ.
And a tournament match.
And a tournament match. And a, at this point, 3 mid-carders as your main event. Because Triple H wasn't really a main event.
Yeah.
Shawn was the main event guy still to this point.
He was just hanging out with John, trying to get the rub. Then we jump over to September 15th of 1997. As Raw is back with Ken Shamrock defeating Farouk in a WWF Intercontinental Title Tournament quarterfinal match in 2 minutes and 42 seconds. That's a fast match there.
We're
on Raw on September 15th.
Ken Shamrock, okay. And then Taka Michinoku defeated Pantera in 3:58.
We had the Legion of Doom, Animal and Hulk, defeating the Truth Commission, Recon, and Sniper via disqualification in 3 minutes and 38 seconds.
Then we have Max Mini and Mr. Lucky, why not keep getting the small people, defeated El Torito, not the guy that was with...
Not the bull dude.
The bull guy, not him. And Pirata Morgan, 6:53. Why is the midget tag team match longer than Ken Shamrock and Farouk?
Thank you.
That is awful.
We have another Intercontinental Title Tournament quarterfinal match. It lasted 4 minutes and 47 seconds as Brian Pillman with Marlena defeated Dude Love by disqualification.
Ooh, now, the sad thing of what I'm thinking about...
No, you're right.
...is this was the very end for Brian Pillman because the last storyline he had was with Marlena.
He didn't make the next pay-per-view.
What was the next pay-per-view?
Right in this way because he won Marlena from Goldust.
Yes. Because apparently in real life, the two of them were together in WCW. And so that's the storyline they were going off of. And so he was getting her back from Goldust. And I remember he won her, and then he started doing these vignettes, like in hotel rooms with her and stuff. Mm-hmm. And then, boom, next thing you know, before the feud could end with him and Goldust, he died.
Yeah.
So sad.
It is.
Is it me?
Yes.
The Patriot defeated Owen Hart in 10:37.
And the main event, the Headbangers, Mosh and Thrasher, defeated Bret Hart and the British Bulldog by DQ in a WWF Tag Team Championship match that lasted 12 minutes and 45 seconds.
And then we go to WCW Monday Night Nitro, September the 15th, as we have 3 dark matches as Bobby Blaze defeated Louis Spagoli.
We also have the next dark match, Chris Adams. Gentleman Chris Adams defeating Kendall Windham.
Barry Windham's a less successful brother.
Really?
And then the last dark match, which I believe is the Berserker.
You're right.
Thank you. John Nord. Was he John Nord in AWA?
Yes.
Okay. And him and Scott Norton were lumberjacks. Defeated.
You mean Vicious?
Vicious and Delicious.
Yes,
John Nord defeated Tim Horner.
I'm sorry. Then we start off with Dean Malenko defeating Disco Inferno in 4 minutes and 12 seconds.
The Faces of Fear, Being a Barbarian, defeated Harlem Heat with Jacqueline, 6:28.
We had Rey Mysterio Jr.
Booyaka.
Defeat Juventud Guerrera.
The Juice.
In 7:03.
We have Alex Wright.
Das Wunderkind.
The WCW World Television Champion defeating Steven Regal to retain his title in 4:33.
The Giant defeated Conan.
Not the Barbarian.
in 303.
It's me. It's DDP. Defeated Stevie Richards in 337.
Up next was a WCW World Tag Team Championship match. It lasted 5 minutes and 59 seconds as your champions, the Outsiders, Hall and Nash, defeated Mortis and Wrath with James Vanderberg.
Which is Father James Mitchell. And then your WCW World Cruiserweight Champion, Eddie Guerrero, Latino Heat, defeated Ultimo Dragon 605. What? Did I say that wrong?
No.
What?
It must have happened in between the damn shows because last week...
Who was the Cruiserweight Champion then?
Jericho!
Maybe there's a pay-per-view.
Because it went Jericho, oh, beat both of them, and Eddie was the second match.
Weird.
And that's the dude who didn't write it up right. And your main event! It's for the WCW United States Championship. It lasted 6 minutes and 33 seconds. As Curt Hennig defeated your champion, Steve Mongo McMichaels, to become the new United States Champion. Good for Curt.
It very well could be right after pay-per-view, because if Curt was facing Steve Mongo McMichaels, that means Curt just turned on the Four Horsemen. Because remember, last week he was with the Four Horsemen with Flair, you know?
That's true.
So it must have been that pay-per-view must have just happened the night before then.
Yeah, we can look on the network, 29
a.m. 999.
So one falls in between the 15th and the 8th.
999. As we then go to...
14th, it should be.
Same thing. Anyway, September 22nd of Nitro. As we have two dark matches as Bruiser... How do you say that? Mastino? Defeated Damien, not the snake.
We have
Six-man.
A Mexican tag team title match.
Not tag team. But titles.
It's a tag team match. It's an dark match. It's El Dandy, El Texaco, and the Aztec Warrior.
Should have been El Aztec.
I know. Defeated Orr Jr.
Orr. O-R-O.
And Super Astro.
All right.
Alrighty then. They get the mix-ins in there. All right.
That's crazy. The opening match was Rey Mysterio Jr., Booyaka.
619.
Defeating Silver King.
Well, Bill Goldberg defeating Hugh Morrus. That might have been his first. Because that was a dark match, I think.
Right.
So this is, it's number one, folks. Here we go.
Looks like it's going to be number one.
Then
we have Disco Inferno defeating his Boogie Nights tag team partner, because I don't think they were tag team partners yet. Alex Wright.
Das Wunderkin.
To win the WCW World Television Championship.
Hector Garza defeated Scott Hall. What?
Who interfered?
Not the NWO.
Somebody had to have interfered.
Not the NWO.
Whoever was feuding with Scott Hall definitely had to interfere in that match. Then we have Cyclops, not from the X-Men, Juventud Guerrero, the Juice, Lizmark Jr., and Ultimo Dragon, defeating La Parka, the chairman of the board, Psychosis, because he's crazy, and Villano IV and Villano V, because Villano VI was busy.
Yes. Now you want to keep going.
It's a lot, wasn't it?
The Faces of Fear, being a barbarian, defeated the Steiner brothers, Rick and Scott Steiner.
Fought a lot on Nitro there, didn't
they? Did.
And then, Randy Macho Man Savage defeated Stevie Richards.
In a 2-on-1 handicap match, Booker T defeated Conan and Scott Norton by DQ.
Wow. And then in your main event for the WCW United States Championship, Curt Hennig, your champion, defeated Jeff Jarrett to retain. So that definitely is what happened. And he turned on the Four Horsemen there.
And we jump over to Raw as Ahmed Johnson defeated Rocky Maivia in a WWF Intercontinental Title Tournament qualifier match in, good God almighty, 4 minutes and 56 seconds.
Now, if you look at the present time and you see who defeated who,
yes,
you know, it's like if they only knew what's going to happen later on,
yes,
Ahmed would not have won that night.
No.
Then we have the Legion of Doom, Animal and Hawk, defeating the Nation of Domination, Farouk and Kama Mustafa by DQ.
Our next match is also a WWF Intercontinental Title Tournament, so it's a semifinal match.
Woo!
All right. It lasted 7 minutes and 12 seconds as Owen Hart defeated Brian Pillman with Marlena by disqualification.
Then we have Cactus Jack defeating Triple H with China in a street fight. 13 minutes and 40 seconds, but that wasn't even good enough to be the main event.
No, because the main event was lasted 12 minutes and 50 seconds as Bret the Hitman Hart defeated Gold Dust.
Interesting.
That was a weird main event.
It's a very weird main event compared to the street fight. Yeah. Then we go over to Raw again, September the 29th, as Vader defeated the British Bulldog by disqualification in 8 minutes, 30 seconds.
We have a WWF Intercontinental Title Tournament semifinal match. It lasted 2 minutes and 29 seconds as Farouk defeated Ahmed Johnson by DQ.
And then, 5 minutes and 38 seconds, Goldust defeated... The what's the one?
Yeah, that one. This card right here. Keep going.
Okay, you got something to say, apparently.
I do.
Goldust defeated the Sultan with the Iron Sheik in 5 minutes and 38 seconds.
Las Baracas, Jesus Castillo, and Jose Athoria. Murder those names. Defeated the Headbangers, Mosh and Thrash, by DQ, the third DQ so far, in a WWF Tag Team Championship match that lasted 10 minutes and 18 seconds.
And then your main event. Wow, a fourth DQ. Goldust is the only one that didn't have a DQ finish. That's why you were saying something about this card. I didn't even read ahead. So The Undertaker defeated Triple H with Chyna and Shawn Michaels by DQ.
That's pretty bad.
Two minutes and three seconds.
Just some board writing on that one.
Four DQ finishes out of 5 matches. There's a problem there.
That is. I can't think of a finish. DQ. I don't know. DQ.
And that right there would be a reason you lost for 83 weeks in a row.
Yep. And we jump over to Nitro. We have 2 dark matches to begin. As we have dark match number 1, the Ultimo Dragon defeated Psychosis.
And your next dark match as Steven Regal defeated Hector Garza.
It's me! It's me! It's DDP. Diamond Dallas Page defeated Buff the Stuff Bagwell.
Who did not have his mama call out of work for him.
Not yet.
Rey Mysterio Jr. Juniorka? I don't know.
Juniorka 619!
Rey Mysterio Jr.
You were trying to do the whole thing.
I really was. I was just trying to bleed it together.
619!
Rey Mysterio Jr. Kabuyaka Buyaka.
That's it.
That's what it was. Defeated El Kanata. What? El
Caliente.
Caliente. I can't read.
I'm just guessing.
I can't read. But it was actually Eddie Guerrero under a mask.
We're guessing. It doesn't say under a mask, but it has Eddie Guerrero out beside, so we're thinking...
He's in a mask.
Which doesn't work. Okay, so you're under a mask and you still lose?
Of course. Because remember, Eddie Guerrero always lost. Remember, that was a storyline in WWE. He never beat Rey Mysterio, and that went all the way back to WCW. Rey never lost to Eddie Guerrero. That was the thing.
Well, you could be a him then. We got Bill Goldberg defeating the Barbarian. 2-0.
We're not going to keep up with
that.
WCW World Television title match as Disco Inferno, your champion, defeated Juventud Guerrero, the Juice.
Jeff Jarrett defeated Steve Mongo McMichael.
Everybody's turning on the fours.
The Bears.
The Bears. The Bears, the Bears, the Bears, the Bears. And then we have Chris Jericho defeating 1, 2, 3, add it together, 6. By TQ.
We have Lex Luger, the total package, defeating Wrath. But who hasn't?
Folks? But really, who hasn't? He was Adam Bomb. Everybody beat him. WCW. United States Heavyweight title match.
I think that's the third week in a row that it was the main event.
Exactly, because Curt Hennig matters to WCW. Not really. Because Hogan was probably champion right now. So they were like, we can't have him on TV.
He's the only one I know, and he's out there talking.
Probably. The Giant defeated Curt Hennig by DQ. Because I guess the Giant was no longer in the NWO at this point. Because that wouldn't have made sense.
Yes.
That wouldn't have made sense at all. Yes. They were both in the NWO.
Yeah, I know. So Curt was probably looking like he was going to get beat, and here comes the NWO to help, and there's your DQ.
There's your DQ.
And I keep the United States title.
At least there wasn't 4 in the whole show. There was at least 2, I see, though.
Yeah, they had a lot more matches, though.
They did have a lot more. To balance out 2 DQs. They didn't have 5 and have 4 DQs.
That
so
hurts.
Raw loses.
That's a hurter there. That's a
but
ill
that
stinking.
Is all of September 1997.
That's it, yes, folks.
We're getting down to the nitty gritty of 1997.
We are. You know what's next?
October.
No, 1998.
Oh. I thought, you know, it's after September's October.
Well, trust me, if you went 1998, that's going to go October, so.
You were going to be wrong
either way.
Whatever you said, yes. But in the next part three, let's talk about the March Macho Madness Tournament, blocks number 3 and 4.
3, 4.
Plus, we're going to recap what happened in Elimination Chamber and tell what was coming up at Fastlane next week.
Ooh.
That's about it for part 3 days. Very short, yep. Very short.
Short but sweet.
Short but sweet. So come on back. I'm Mike Hogan.
And I'm Justin Carter.
We'll see you in a few clicks right here at Top Rope Reality for part 3 of episode 155. Nothing new, huh? Don't give me the finger.